breakthroughs. Even a time like now, I say financial breakthroughs, economic breakthrough. No matter the time, our time is. Badagadagadugataya. Tenebo sokatarania. Teria bashekatanabakos.
Samuel 28. I'll share with us briefly what I'm calling your strength in times of battles, because that is a type of freedom. It'll be more like a declaration or something. 1 Samuel chapter 28. Hallelujah. We are told there from verse 4, and the Philistines gathered themselves together. The Philistines, who were constant enemies of Israel, and came and pitched in Shunem, and Saul gathered all Israel together and pitched in Gibeah. And when Saul saw the host of the Philistines, he was afraid, and his heart greatly trembled when he saw the host of the Philistines. Remember that he has already gathered the entire army of Israel. But when he saw the army of the Philistines, when he saw, before they engaged, when he saw the armies of Philistines, he was afraid and his heart greatly trembled. No matter what you have seen from the enemy's camp, no matter what situations that have come your way, I declare from this hour, you shall not tremble. You shall not fear whatever you see. Are you saying an amen to that? And when Saul inquired of the Lord, that is like to pray to God, to ask the Lord, neither by dreams, nor by Urim, nor by prophets. That is very important and very key verse. He went to the Lord, but the Lord did not answer him, neither by dreams, nor by Urim, nor by prophets. Then said Saul unto his servants, seek me a woman that hath a familiar spirit, that I may go to her and inquire of her. And his servant said unto him, behold, there is a woman that has a familiar spirit at Endor. Now, I want to speak quickly on what I'm calling gaining strength, or your strength in the days of battle, in times of battle. In the times of battle, you will need strength. And the strength that you so need for the day of battle, in the times of battle, is the voice of God. And Saul knew, because before this, he has gone to the battle many times and he had gained victory. But something was wrong this time, because the Lord had departed from him. The spirit of the Lord had departed from him, and an evil spirit had come upon him, which troubled him much. So the garrison and the army of Philistine has come in battle. And Saul is going to seek for the strength by seeking the voice of God. Oh God, speak. Because the voice of God is your strength in the day of battle. But lo and behold, he cannot hear. God is not speaking to him. God is not speaking to him. So that means he cannot get strength for the day of battle. And we are told that the Lord did not speak to him, number one, by Urim and Thummim. I mean the dreams, then Urim, and even by the prophets. So you are going to find that there are three ways that God majorly speaks to men. If you are going to hear the voice of God, especially for the times of battle, and remember, we are constantly in battle. Whether you know it or not, there is always a spiritual warfare going on. There is always a contention Because Paul said that a great and effectual door is set before me, and there are many adversaries. There are many adversaries. There are many adversaries. 1 Corinthians 16 verse 9. There are many adversaries. The kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. If you see a man that is taking his possession in the kingdom, it did not just come by coming. It was taken by force. Because the kingdom suffered violence. There is a war going on. Things that are not happening for you and things that are happening against you, they are not just things happening. It is a warfare happening. And in such a time when you are confronted by negative circumstances, a warfare against you, the kingdom of Satan and darkness raging against you, you will need to hear the voice of God so that you can receive strength. Because the voice of God is majestic. The voice of God is powerful. The voice of God breaketh the cedars of Lebanon. The voice of the Lord splits and divideth the flames of fire. Psalms 29. It is the voice of God that shall give you victory. Without the voice of God in the day of trouble, you cannot overcome. Without hearing the voice of God in the day of battle, you will become a victim. So Saul is looking for that voice. But that voice is elusive. God is not speaking to him, not by dreams. So number one way God speaks to us, how you can hear the voice of God, is by dreams. Somebody say dreams. I'm not hearing. Say louder, dreams. Say louder, dreams. Dream, God can speak to you through dreams and visions. We are told again in Job 33 verse 12, verse 14, that God speaks once. Yes, he speaks twice. In the dreams of the night, in dreams and in visions of night, verse 14. God speaks once and even twice, verse 14. For God speaketh once, twice, yet man perceiveth it not. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falleth upon men, in slumberings upon the bed. So one of the ways God would want to speak to you is through dreams. And you need the voice of God to gain strength in the day of battle. Hallelujah. On Tuesday, that should be this Monday. On Monday night, I had a visitation, very special one. To me, it was very special. In the dreams of the night and the visions of the night, I had Bishop Edepo come. I was carrying him in my car, and I was taking him to a meeting. Then the same night, I had an encounter again. I saw myself in the house of Kenneth Copeland. Do you know who is Kenneth Copeland? Yeah, I was dining together with him as a family. And to me, that is not just a dream. Because God speaks in a dream, in a vision of the night. When deep sleep falleth upon men, in slumberings upon the bed. God can use dreams to speak to you. And he will empower you. And that's why the devil would want to fight your dream life. Because he knows the moment you encounter the voice of God in that avenue, you'll be so powerful that he cannot be able to overcome you. Is that the reason why some people will see dreams and forget the dreams? Is that why some people will have dreams and the dreams are interrupted or complicated? Is that why somebody will have a dream and not have the interpretation? Because the enemy knows that through the dreams, you can hear the voice of God. You can dream one dream. And it is not just an occupation in the spiritual realm or something about your spirit at night. It is God speaking to you. Ask Joseph. He had one dream. Actually, there were two. Two dreams that shaped his destiny. You need dream, or you need dreams in your dream. You can write it somewhere there. You need dreams in your dream. The dream here is your vision for life. The dream here is your assignment, your purpose for life. Joseph saw two dreams. And the two dreams, they were not just something happening. It was actually God speaking to him about the future. Thank God that he was able to position himself and he was able to make the dream become a reality because he had dreams that he was able to understand. As the man called Pharaoh. Pharaoh had a dream. Unfortunately for him, because he did not have the spirit of God, he could not understand. He could not have the interpretation thereof. He needed someone to come and talk to him about the dream that he dreamt last night. And thank God that the dreams were interpreted by Joseph. And when the dreams were interpreted for Joseph, they got a solution. And the future of Egypt was preserved against the day of battle called famine for 7 years. I am declaring to you in Jesus' mighty name, your dream life shall be restored in Jesus' mighty name. Is that why the devil, you see, anywhere you find the enemy doing something, that means there is another side that God is doing something good. He says, I know the plans I have for you, they are for good. So on the other side, the devil has evil plans on a daily basis. So God speaks through dreams. The enemy would want to sabotage your dream life by giving evil dreams. Evil dreams. Is that why some people are, their life, their dream life has been captured by the enemy? They see themselves through the night under captivity and slavery of the enemy. They are loaded with loads and burdens. They wake up frightened and terrorized. I declare to you today that by the grace of God today, your dream life shall be restored. Are you saying an amen to that? Lift up both of your hands and say, in Jesus' mighty name, Father, I pray, let my dream life be restored. Yeah. May you see dreams that make your dream. May you see dreams that shape your future. May you see dreams when you wake up, you know God is speaking to you. May you see dreams when you rise up, you will know what God is saying. Are you saying an amen to that? I sanctify your bedroom in Jesus' mighty name. I sanctify your bed in Jesus' mighty name. No more demonic dreams in your life. I declare your dream life shall be sanctified. For God speaketh once, even twice. That is, God can give you one dream today and another one. He speaks once and even twice in the dreams and in the visions of the night. You will see things. I say you will see things. I say you will see things. Things of the kingdom. You can have the secrets revealed to you. Hallelujah. There are things that God is showing about, is showing me about this country. And some of them, I don't have to announce them on the microphone. Because if I tell you some of the things I'm seeing, and God is showing me, you will maybe not understand. I have many things to say to you. But as of now, you may not understand. So I keep them until the appointed time. And this one is helping me. And maybe a few people that I may engage here and there for prayer. Hallelujah. Because they are sacred things. God has general things and God has sacred things. There is the bread for everybody, but there is also the bread for the children. The sacred things belong to God. But the things that are revealed, they belong to us. So God has secrets. Jesus told his disciples that everything unto them is said in parables, but unto you it is given to understand the mysteries of the kingdom. You will know things beyond the natural state of things in Jesus' mighty name. Lift up and say, in the name of Jesus, Father, I pray, let my dream life be restored. Amen. God can reveal things about your family, about your children, about your job, about your business, about your health in the dream. So that through that voice, you can know how to fight the battle. You cannot hear the voice of God and you are timid. You cannot hear the voice of God and you are terrorized. You will have the boldness of a lion. Are you saying an amen to that? Because the voice of God is majestic. The voice of the Lord is powerful. the voice of the Lord will make the mountains to move. Are you saying an amen to that? Hallelujah. Number two way God speaks to us is by what Saul was trying to hear the voice of God through, called Urim. U-R-I-M. Urim. So Saul tried to hear the voice of God through the dream. God was not speaking. He tried to hear the voice of God through Urim. Now, when the Lord called the nation of Levites, of the tribe of Levites, among the sons, among the tribes of Israel, these were special people. There was a group of people that carried the ephod. Ephod was something they put on their chest here. And when they wanted to know what God is saying, the priest will check to see here on the ephod, because there was on one side the Urim and the other side called something called Thummim. Urim and Thummim. So they would check on it. For example, how did they know that it is a time for them to move? How did they know it was a time for them to stay? They were getting the answer through Urim and Thummim. So Urim stands for the Rhema word. Thummim stands for the Logos. So it's the word of God. The word of God. God speaking to you through his word. And then the word of God has the Thummim and the Urim. Thummim means the logo. And Urim, the Rhema. Like when you sit down with the scriptures, God can speak to you. God can speak to you through scriptures. And you don't remain on Thummim, the Logos. Logos means the written. The written as you're reading. For example, you may find somebody who is able to quote Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He may quote that. At that level of just knowing the scripture and quoting it, that is Thummim, the Logos. The Logos. And many people, they are just quoting the scripture on the face value, but they do not have an in-depth revelation of what the scripture is saying. So after Thummim, you should be able to proceed to what is called the Urim. The Urim is the Rhema word, the revealed word. Because in the Logos, there is a revealed word. In the written word, there is a message inside. Are you saying an amen to that? For example, you have heard me say, a woman came to me, she had miscarried several times, and she was almost giving up because they said, her womb is so weak, it cannot carry a child. So by the time the child was 3 months in the womb, the weight of the child could not be held again by the uterus. So she would always miscarry, always miscarry. Then went to the scriptures. And we saw that he upholds all things by the power of his word. Or by the power of his word. He upholds all things. Immediately, we moved from the Logos, the Thummim, the general scripture quoting. And we began to see something. Because he's also the one that created the earth. He's the one that created the earth by his wisdom. We are told that the earth is suspended in space. It is not attached to anything. Just hang there, suspended. It has never run away. It has never fallen away. It has never become chaotic. It is still in place. Now for many years, the earth is still in order. The sun rising after every 12 hours. And moving round, always in order. There is no chaotic situation. The waters are not falling apart. I asked the lady, if God is able to uphold the whole earth, and he is upholding it by the same power of the word, because the earth was created by his word, how comes he cannot uphold the child in your womb for 9 months? And we enter to Urim, the Rhema word, the revealed word. And we were able to use that scripture. And we prayed that through that, the same way God upholds the whole earth in space for the many years now, is the same way his hand and his word is able to uphold the child of this woman for the next 9 months. And she conceived and she carried the child to term and the child was delivered. I hope you're getting what I'm talking about. If you want to hear the voice of God, the voice of God is not just in simple scripture quoting. You can quote scriptures and nothing happens. You need to go to the depth. The rhema. What is God saying to me now? Are you saying an amen to that? And every scripture has the voice of God inside of it. The letter killeth, but the spirit giveth life. Move from the letters and go to the spirit. The words that I speak to you, they are life and spirit. Go for the spirit. In the world of law, you hear something like the spirit of the law. You will hear two lawyers talking about this is the letter of the law and this is the spirit of the law. And they are trying to interpret. You keep hearing them saying the law is clear. But beyond the letter of the law, there is the spirit of the law. Are you getting something? So it is in the scripture. Every scripture written in the Bible has a voice of God inside of it. You will need to stretch yourself. And this is through meditation. For this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth. Day and night. Somebody say day and night. Not sometimes. It is day and night. That means every day, during the day and during the night. It is not once in a week. It is not once in a month. You will need to meditate on it. He said, you shall meditate on this word. When you read the scripture just like this, you are reading it just like the headline of the newspaper. But when you sit down and study with the help of the Holy Spirit, with a focus into it, then you begin to move from Thummim to Urim, the revelation. Are you getting something here now? In the name of Jesus. Now let's lift up and say, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for the country Kenya. This is a great country. And we are declaring today that the floods come to an end. There will be no floods anymore in this country. In the name of Jesus, we take authority. We speak to the clouds. We speak to the heavens. Let there be no more clouds or floods in this country. Begin to declare in your own way now. Begin to declare in your own way. Begin to declare in your own way. Tandabo shakatalabaka. Tandabo shakatalabakaya. Tendemo shakatalabakaya. There shall be no more floods. No more floods in this country. 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 We declare today cessation of floods in the name of Jesus. Continue declaring. Continue declaring. There shall be no more floods. No more floods in this country. We country jidegegeteka. No more rains that are causing havoc. No more rains that are carrying people. No more rains that are damaging infrastructure. No more rains that are killing people. We decrease cessation of floods in this country. In the mighty name of Jesus. From corner to corner, from the north to south, from the east to west, in the name of Jesus. Tendemo shakata.
Wow. I believe, my dear viewer, you've been blessed by this program that is lighting your world, that is coming to you on this channel. This program, remember, it comes to you every Friday, that is 8:30 p.m. to 9 p.m. I'm Bishop Patrick Kariuki of Great Gospel Visionaries International. I would like to pray with somebody who says, I am not born again. I want to give my life to Jesus. Or somebody who backslid, or somebody who is not very certain or sure about his salvation. This is your time for salvation. This will guarantee the kingdom life here on earth and also eternity with Christ in the time to come. So wherever you are, you don't have to wait until Sunday You don't have to consult with your friends, because this is a matter between you and Christ Jesus. If you believe, he will come into your heart and he will make you his son. If you believe in your heart and confess, you shall be saved. Wherever you are, please, meaningfully, from the depth of your heart, it doesn't matter where you are, you will pray together with me and Jesus will become the Lord. Say, Lord Jesus, today I make this decision to receive you as Lord and my Savior. Forgive my sins and my wrongs. Write my name in the book of life. I confess that you are my Savior. And I receive of your love, and by faith, by the grace of God, I confess I'm born again. The past is gone, and the new has come. I am born again. Amen. Congratulations. You just made it to the kingdom of God. Now you're a son of God. You're a child of God. Men and women alike, you're not born again. If you've made that decision, you made that prayer, indeed there's no doubt that you're born again. I will encourage you to look for a church that believes in the Bible, that prays, that believes in the Holy Spirit, in the power of God, and be a disciple there. You are going to grow in the things of God, and you are going to become more what God wants you to be. Now, I want to pray with those that you are sick in your body, you have any pain in your body, you have been diagnosed by the doctor of any disease. There is nothing that is impossible. Jesus said, if two of you, two or three shall agree on any matter, then he shall do it for you. Whatever you are, if you can be able to touch the place of pain, then you can touch the place. If you cannot be able to touch the place, maybe an internal organ, then you may place your hand on your chest, wherever you are. I pray now and have faith and believe, because Jesus is ever a healing Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for my viewer right now. I declare healing virtue right now in their homes, right now in that bed of sickness. And I command healing in Jesus' name. I declare by the stripes of Jesus they were healed. Your body is a temple of the Holy Ghost. I rebuke the spirit of infirmity and disease and sickness. You shall not die but live to declare the praises of God. By faith right now, receive your healing and you shall have a testimony to the glory of God the Father in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I believe you have received your miracle, do not doubt. You'd like to communicate with us, please call that number. Let us know what Jesus has done so that we can glorify God together with you. And Jesus is Lord. Remember, the same time again, coming Friday on this Lighting Your World. You are most welcome. The Lord bless you and have a wonderful time. Have a wonderful year 2018. It shall be a great year for you. The Lord bless you.
You see, in life you've got to remember, you either write history, read history, make history, or become history.
8th to the 10th, the month of May, it's going to be a great time, that second week. I want you to mark that date. It's not far from now. We'll be having one of generals of our time in the kingdom. Apostle Richard Mayanja is a great blessing to the body of Christ. All the way from the country of Uganda, he will be ministering live in what we are calling the Higher Life Summit. You are most welcome at Great Gospel Visioners from 8th to the 10th at Great Gospel Visioners International.
Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, nothing